Those of us of a certain age, reserve railways are a great way of remembering our long-gone distant youth. A chance to relive again those hazy days of summer, when armed only with a bottle of Tizer, a pack of jam sarnies, and that Bible of the young train spotter, the Ian Allen engine number book, well, we'd sit for hours on end line side, waiting for that coal-stained Black Five hauling a freight to appear. Even a sighting of a fabled Britannia, stormy pretty countryside with some packed express bound for the distant seaside. But alas, those days have, like our youth now, long gone. Now, alongside quiet, electric suburban trains, diesel-powered high-speed trains race through the countryside to frighten the nine-side cows and sheep. And as for those old steam locos, well, those that were saved from the scrap heap have ended up in places like this. Preserved steam railway line, where for a few short hours an older generation can again relive the sights and sounds of a bygone golden age. Which is fine for us oldsters, but how do you interest the next generation into the wonders and excitement of a powerful steam locomotive in full cry? Well, one way is this annual event here at the Colne Valley Railway at Castle Headingham, where for 1 week its staff and volunteers slip into costume to step back in time to the early 1900s to try and recreate an Edwardian atmosphere as an educational experience for the area's young school children. And as you can see, it seems to work, for throughout this early October week, schools all around our six, coachloads of local children, many of them clad in their homemade mini versions of Edwardian costume, crowd into this North Essex Working Museum. For many, as they crowd onto the platform, it's often their first sight, and indeed smell, of a steam locomotive under power.
This isn't, the points are locked. So
for others, a chance to climb into the line signal box to see behind the scenes. For these young minds, this is a chance to see basic engineering in action. On this railway, electronics have no part. It's all down to levers and metal rods to control the signalling.
When it's in that position, I tell them to slow down.
Deborah Carter.
So just what, if any, is the educational value of a school visit such as this? An answer from this teacher from a Harwich-based primary school.
Well, it fulfils part of the national curriculum. We're doing a topic at the moment on the Victorians, and this all fits in beautifully, and they've got the school room this afternoon where they have a real Victorian lesson, and they meet Queen Victoria on the train.
Oh, God bless her.
So it all fits in beautifully, and it brings history alive.
But for all the exhibits, the educational talks, and yes, the chance for the many junior visitors to play a part in this educational fantasy, to ride in a real-life steam train up and down the short section of line that was the main draw for the children. But how many of these children, I wonder, realise that this small locomotive hauling their train was a loco with a history all of its own? For this was victory. An old naval pensioner and a veritable dockyard matey that had down the years seen service chugging around Chatham Naval Dockyard.
We like the abilities because there's the Punch and Judy, the singing, and there's all kinds of stuff. Like, you get to see the weaving and you get to see the box where they guide the trains. It's very nice.
And dreams is what the Colne Valley Railway is all about. For those of us past the first flush of our youth, it offers a few hours to relive our distant childhood days when, Wanting to be a loco driver was our one ambition. And for tomorrow's generation, a chance to discover that there is a romance about railways after all. And that for some lucky folk, well, dreams do come true.